On Jurassic Park.
Back with you on WCW Saturday Night, and we head towards Spring Stampede. As a matter of fact, it's nearly 2 weeks away from this weekend. One of the big matches will be the Boss against Vader. Wow, what a matchup that'll be.
You know his first name?
The Boss?
He.
Not the.
Nobody's named Boss. I heard, now this is just a rumor, I heard his name is Buford.
Wait a minute.
Yeah. Buford. He looks like a Buford.
Chris Pullen is the... is the opponent. The Boss sends on the outside.
Where's Buford now?
Well, there he is.
That's a nice haircut he's got if you're going to the chair.
And the Boss with a right hand on the chin of Chris Pullen.
Oh, shut up.
All right.
Why don't you go back to Marietta and be a meter maid like you used to do.
Easy, Marietta's a pretty darn nice place.
Yes, the city limit signs are standing on the same post.
One of the biggest and baddest in WCW, the Boss.
But he shouldn't cut his own hair, you can tell.
What, you think he cuts his own?
Well, you think a guy would, you think a barber would take credit for that?
It wouldn't be very difficult.
If they hung the barber that cut his hair for being a barber, they'd hang an innocent man.
The Boss and Vader will collide at Spring Stampede, Sunday, April 17th. We will start at 7 o'clock Eastern Time. Of course, that's 6 o'clock local Chicago time. The Boss missed. Chris Pillen now. See the Boss.
Not with one hand, punk. You're not going to do that to him. Ever been any grits in that goatee?
What are you trying to say?
Man's a slob. Simple. I don't pull any punches, Tony.
Well, you sure have a big punch. You sure don't. And you can better believe when Vader and the Boss collide.
You know, think of this. This man here is 30 pounds? He's a big man, right?
Yes, Buford. Right.
The Boss.
But Vader is twice the size of him almost.
The spike slam.
You won't do that to Vader.
Well, I think you're right about that, but it is going to be quite a collision.
What a match that's going to be.
That's a gigantic grudge match. And you'll recall what happened at Super Brawl. The Boss was instrumental. And Ric Flair retaining the title. As a matter of fact, Vader and you both say that Vader never gave up.
Did you hear him give up?
Well, no, I didn't really hear him give up, but the Boss is...
Where's he going now? Wait a minute.
He's going to go down and talk to Mean Gene Okerlund.
And there it is. 3-point conversion. Went to Mike Cuspin. I guarantee you he won't be doing this to Vader. He'll be at the other end of that move.
Let's go to Mean Gene Okerlund.
All right, fans, you've just seen him in action. He is the Boss, and he is going to be in action 2 weeks from tomorrow night in Chicago at the Spring Stampede as he tackles the big 450-pound Vader. I've got a feeling this is going to be a grudge match to end all grudge matches.
Well, you know, Vader attacking me and handcuffing me to that ring, all that was fate asking me to dance. And as you can well see, I'm good to go. Bottom line is, this nightstick, it's just an instrument of justice, just like the Boss is. What really counts is them fans in the stands and all them millions back on pay-per-view watching, hoping that justice is served, because they're our peers, they're our equals, and they are the judges. And without a doubt, punk, they say that you are guilty as charged. Spring Stampede, Chicago. I will make sure that justice is served beyond the shadow of a doubt. You're going to be beaten beyond recognition, because one way or the other, Harley Race, Vader, justice is going to be served. And you can count on it, because there's millions of people across this country that believe in me. And I believe in them. And you can count on it.
I should point out that the Boss has got a tremendous contingent of fans in the Windy City of Chicago. Spring Stampede coming up 2 weeks from tomorrow night on pay-per-view. We're back after this.